Hey guys, C-Drama Invasion here. Welcome back to a new video. Today, as usual, there are so many new upcoming dramas and dramas that recently wrapped up filming. So there's so much to cover today, so let's just jump on into it. But make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and check the link out in the description box if you haven't seen the rest of these C-Drama news episodes. I've covered so many lately. Now let's start off with recently aired dramas such as The World of Fantasy, which was also called Spirit Realm before. This drama stars Fan Cheng Cheng and also Cheng Xiao. This drama aired on January 9th on iQIYI with 36 episodes, and this is an action, historical, martial arts fantasy drama. Even though I haven't seen either of the leads in a drama before, but the trailer looks so good and I can't wait to start this drama. Next up is a sweet campus romance web drama called The Most Beautiful You in the World, starring Ho Dong and Huo Pei Shen. This drama premiered on January 12 on Tencent Video. And the next big drama that came out is My Little Happiness, starring Fair Xing Fei and Tang Xiao Tian, or Daddy Tang. This reminds me so much of Put Your Head on My Shoulder. It has the same cute rom-com drama. So if you're into this genre, make sure to check it out and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Now let's move on to dramas that has recently finished shooting. The first one I'd like to mention is Sweet Teeth, which has the same director as Crossfire, and this stars Wu Xuanyi and Bai Wenjun. This drama should air on iQIYI as well, and it recently wrapped up filming after only 76 days. This has 24 episodes. It is a romance medical drama between a librarian and a doctor. Another sweet drama to look forward to is Ding Yuxi and Yu Shuxin's, or Esther Yu's, Moonlight, which follows a romance between an author and a newbie in the writing industry, how they work together in real life, and how they also fall in love online. As usual, all of the names of these dramas mentioned will be listed in the description box, so make sure to check that out afterwards. Anyways, here are some of the photos. This looks so cute, and it reminds me of a Japanese-style anime or manga. And since it's the beginning of the year, hopefully they'll have enough time to edit this drama down so we can get it in the second half of 2021, if we're lucky. And the last drama I'd like to mention is Love Cross, which is by the same team behind Love is Sweet, which is super popular. This drama will star a newer actor named He Luo Luo, who has been on Produce Camp in 2019. This will be his first debut role, and not much is given about this drama, but so far the synopsis says that it's based on some online gaming and romance. The female lead in this drama will be played by Dai Luhua, who is also an upcoming actress. She has recently been in the drama Crossfire. Now let's move on to the follow-up for the Guo Jingming news, the one about plagiarism. So recently, netizens discovered that all of his upcoming screenings for his movie On Myoji, which is the one with Deng Lun and also Mark Chow, has been cancelled and pulled out of theaters only after a week or two of airing. The movie premiered on December 25th, and it seems that the consequences for their actions has become much more serious now. The boycott thing seems to work, and apparently there is news that there will be rules and regulations that will be stricter in 2021 on production companies and anything dealing with plagiarism. Still, Netflix did buy the license to it, so I don't know if They will still release it in February as planned, since they did buy the license for it internationally. I would love to see it. I know that on one hand, it's bringing more money to the pockets of the producers who plagiarize, but at the same time, there's people like Mark Chow and Deng Lin who worked incredibly hard on the movie itself, so it wouldn't be completely fair for them either. Rumors has it that big dramas such as The Song of Youth and also Royal Feast. The Song of Youth stars Bai Lu, a actress under Yu Zheng's production, and the later one that I mentioned, Royal Feast, stars Xu Kai and Wu Jinyan, and other Yu Zheng or Guo Jingming productions will not air in 2021 because they don't want to give these producers any more publicity. What are your thoughts on this issue? Make sure to comment down below. And next up is a little sweet news of Jackson Yi and his fans, who he was recently in the film A Little Red Flower, which is a very heartwarming and realistic story about a family that is trying to fight illness, heal, and deal with someone who has cancer together. He complimented his fans and responds to them donating their hair to cancer patients as a charity to support his film, and says that his fans always learn things through his works and they always do meaningful things to society, which he is very proud of. I also love it when actors, actresses, or any celebrities with a bigger following uses their fan base for good, and it's really nice to see him just give back to society and his fans do the same. Now let's talk about the controversy with A Twisted Fate of Love's star Jin Han. His co-star, the female lead in the drama, mentions on a live video that before kissing him, her mouth felt numb in the kissing scenes because he always ate crayfish, which was quite unpleasant after they filmed all the kissing scenes. Crayfish is quite a popular dish in China. It can be made many ways. It usually includes very pungent smells or very strong seasonings. There's a lot of garlic, lemon juice, and sometimes a lot of spices. So it's definitely understandable why it's not ideal to kiss someone after eating. He received further backlash by some fans who found a photo and also video footage behind the scenes of him smoking before filming a kissing scene as well. So obviously the fans were enraged and they called him disrespectful, inconsiderate. And one of the top comments says, "Do you not consider a bit of feelings for female celebrities, a man with such poor character?" What are your thoughts on this? Personally, I think that I side with Sun Yi and the commenters for this one, since I thought he could have refrained from eating these things and smoking until after the scene was done. I really feel bad for Sun Yi. Now let's count down the top 5 Douban's 2020 highest rated Chinese dramas. Douban is a more critical Asian drama or movies platform that is based on movie critics alone, which is why the ones chosen on this list usually have deeper themes, a well-written story. They pay attention to details that normal viewers will miss, such as editing, sound, dubbing, and little things like that. So usually the ones that count isn't just the acting or the story, it's also the quality of the drama itself. At number 5, we have With You, which was rated at 8.7. This is a 20-episode medical life drama anthology about the ongoing pandemic, with many popular actors each acting out their own little story related to the pandemic. Some of these notable actors are Feng Xiaofeng, Yang Yang, Deng Lin, and Johnny Huang. This drama is available on YouTube with English subtitles. In 4th place is The Gutter, which has an 8.9 rating with 15 episodes. This is a Hong Kong mystery romance drama starring Bowie Lam and Catherine Cho. In third place is The Bad Kids, which is part of the Light On series with 12 episodes and stars Chin Hao along with many new rising actors. This is a psychological thriller drama that deals a lot with life as well as poverty and crime. In second place is The Long Night, also a part of the Light On series, also with 12 episodes and is a psychological crime thriller starring Johnny Bai or Bai Yu. And last but not least, in first place is Someday or One Day, with also a 9.2 on Douban. This drama stars Alice Ke and Greg Su. This drama has 13 episodes and is about romance, life, and time travel. Alice Ke is one of my favorite actresses of all time. I've been saving this drama personally since I love the actress so much, and I refuse to watch it unless she comes out with another drama after this. But it's definitely a good one. If you want to know more about it, search up the trailer or the music video. And let me know in the comments down below if you've watched any of these top 5 dramas. What are your thoughts? Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Check out the links in the description if you haven't caught up to the previous episodes. And I'll see you next time. Bye.